Hey everyone, this is Colin with Easy Aviation English, and in this video, we will be talking about bird strikes. But first, let's define what a bird strike is. A bird strike is basically a collision between a bird or a flock of birds and an aircraft. It usually occurs close to an airport, either during the takeoff or landing phase of flight. Contributing factors that may increase the risk of bird strikes include the seasonal migration where large flocks of birds fly large distances. A bird's habitat may be located close to an airport. Bird's habitat may include landfill, as you see in this photo, as well as any bodies of water, such as lakes or ponds. Encountering a bird in flight can be dangerous because it can cause significant damage to an airplane. A bird strike may damage an aircraft's windscreen, as you can see in this photo, as well as an aircraft's wing, or even engine. Probably the most famous example of a bird strike that everyone remembers occurred in 2009 when a US Airways flight departing New York's LaGuardia Airport hit multiple birds, causing an engine failure in both engines. But luckily, the aircraft successfully landed in the Hudson River. Some ways to reduce the risk of a bird strike include advisories, either from air traffic control or other pilots in the area, warning of birds, as well as noise generators, such as this propane cannon that's designed to startle birds. Another alternative is the capture and relocation of birds away from an airport. So here are a few words I want you all to remember from today's lesson. The first one is flock, or group of birds. Collision, which is an object hitting against another. Hazard, which is the threat or possibility of danger, and advisory, an announcement or warning of danger. But before we leave, I want to ask you a few questions. What airports that you know of have the highest threat of bird strikes? What do you do to prevent bird strikes when you fly? And what would you do if you hit a bird during takeoff? I want to thank you all for watching this short video, and if you want to keep practicing your English, then please visit my website at www.easyaviationenglish.com.